In this chapter, we will be seeing what are the different ways in which we can configure initial load. So as you see here, this is the overview of initial load. If you see the architecture, this is the usual Golden Gate processes wherein we extract the data, put it in the trial file, and using data pump, we send it to the remote trial file, and there is a replicate process which replicates the data into the target database. But before we configure our normal Golden Gate process, we need to make sure that your target database and source databases are in sync. That means this could be your production database and you are going to clone your target database. So what are the different ways in which we can clone our target database? For example, if your source database and target database both are homogeneous databases, then you can use the respective cloning methodology. For example, if this is an Oracle database and your target database is also an Oracle database, you can use Oracle cloning methodologies. But what if your target database is a heterogeneous database? For example, if your source database is an Oracle database and target database is a SQL Server database, in that case, you cannot use the normal database cloning methodologies because your source and target databases are of different RDBMS versions, right? So that is why we use a Golden Gate method known as initial load. So using this initial load method, irrespective of the source and target databases, the initial load can be done. That means you can bring your target database in sync with your source database. So before we proceed, we will see what are the advantages of using Golden Gate initial load method. So using Golden Gate initial load method, as I said, it works across heterogeneous databases. Your source and target databases could be of different RDBMS vendors. So you can use the initial load methodology of Golden Gate to bring your target database in sync with your source database before you start the actual Golden Gate process. That is point number one. Point number two, no application downtime is required. You need not bring your source database down, right? So that is point number two, which means no application downtime is required. Three, it can read directly from the source tables. Your Golden Gate initial load methodology can read from the source database tables, right? And it can fetch data in a race to speed performance. If you are doing an initial load of huge data, you can fetch the data in a race, which is basically used for speeding up the initial load processes. You can use parallel processing also using this where clauses and range functions. Like these are functions or where clauses that you can use in SQL, right? And distribute data over multiple network controllers. You can use multiple network controllers and you can do distribution of data across, like if you want to move data across different databases, or you can use multiple network adapters to distribute the data across different processes, right? And you can also use flexible load alternatives or native bulk load utilities. For each and every version or each and every vendor of databases, there is a specific bulk load utility. For example, for Oracle, there is a SQL loader. You can use this bulk load utilities to load the data as an initial load, right? Golden Gate change delivery can handle collisions. If your target database is already having the data for which you are doing the initial load, then your Golden Gate initial load can actually handle those collisions. That means database unique constraint errors and all. Now, what are the prerequisites? The basic prerequisites for handling initial load is you first disable the DDL. That means you need to disable the DDL, data definition languages. Like you are creating any new objects on your source database, like creation of tables or altering of tables in the source database needs to be stopped, right? Prepare the target tables. You need to prepare your target database. That means whatever are the tables that are there in your source database, you need to create those same tables in the target database as well, right? Configure the manager processes. As I said, you need to configure the manager processes on your source and target database. And create data definition file. Why do we need this data definition file? If your source and target databases are heterogeneous, say are of different RDBMS vendors, then you need to create your data definition file. Or if your source and target database tables are of different structure, that means if your source is having a one structure of a table and your target database is having a different structure, then you need to create this data definition file. And finally, you can create the initial load groups. For doing initial load, there are various methods which we will be seeing in the next video. For doing that initial load, you need to configure this extract group and replicate group specifically for this initial load. So that groups you need to configure. Those groups are known as change synchronization groups. In the next video, we will be seeing what are the different initial load methods.